Somewhere in China, the future of gaming and AI is being built. In a nation of 1.4 billion people, technology isn't just innovation, it's a heartbeat of progress. And at the center of it all, here in Shenzhen, stands the home of Tencent, a global powerhouse leading the way in gaming, cloud computing, and AI. And there is one event where Tencent brings together its brightest minds. That event is
the Tencent Cloud International Summit 2025.
Just to give you a sense of space, on the left, Tencent is showcasing local solutions. Everything from AI digital copy of yourself to e-commerce. And on the right is international solutions like EdgeOne Network, cloud gaming, and media services. But we'll get into that later in the video.
Now there's a high-stake competition happening. It's the EdgeOne Global Hackathon with a top prize of up to $10,000. This competition invites top students and developers from around the world to use Tencent EdgeOne Network to build a game or app from scratch, all within a very short 48 hours. Right now, these teams are deep in development. We'll come back later to see what they've built and find out who takes home the grand prize. But now, let's get back to the booth area and really understand what Tencent has to offer.
To kick things off, we need to talk about one of Tencent's most important technologies, EdgeOne. EdgeOne is an all-in-one solution that combines speed, security, and intelligence in one single global network. Because traditionally, if you wanted to build a game or app for the global audience, you needed to rent servers, set up complicated infrastructures, and spend money and time managing it all. And for most people and small teams, that's nearly impossible. That's where EdgeOne comes in, where they lower the barrier to entry, allowing developers to focus on the creative work instead of the technical side. And with AI integrated directly into the network, EdgeOne doesn't just deliver content faster. It predicts network traffic, optimizes performance, and protects against threats in real time, all without needing a massive back-end team or budget. And I believe that was the whole reason for the hackathon. Three students with 48 hours to complete a fully functional game or application is quite insane. And now that we get into the foundation, let's get into one of the interesting, innovative tech. When it comes to identity verification, usually you think about facial verification or fingerprint. But facial recognition can come with privacy concerns. And fingerprint scanners can be unhygienic if it's in public and at a large scale. PalmAI takes a different approach. Your palm is as unique as your face or fingerprint. The shape of your hand, the lines, and even the veins in your hands. This creates a one-of-a-kind identifier. In terms of hardware size, it's surprisingly simple. You have a regular camera that takes pictures of the lines and the shape. And there's another infrared camera that goes through to see your veins. And once you register your palm in the system, you can use it as a payment. And all you have to do is simply hover over the device. This technology is already implemented in China and Thailand. None of this would be possible without AI. There are millions of possible variations in palm data. And AI is what processes all that complexity, identifying each user accurately and efficiently in real time. Here is a real life example of how the tech can be used. There's an AI interface you can order your drink.
Did you mean hot Americano or ice Americano?
Ice.
You've ordered one cup of ice Americano. The total is 20 yuan. You can use WeChat Palm Pay to complete the payment. Have a great day.
I have also. I register. No problem.
Now the next booth showcases the long-range connectivity of EdgeOne system.
So this robot is pretty cool. There's this VR glasses that I have, and what you can actually do is, like, this is in Shanghai, and you can remotely control the robot in a different state or even a different country. Let's try to do something. With the VR headset, it's a playthrough, so I can actually see my controller, and there's a screen. Basically what you see at the back. Takes a bit of getting used to the orientation. I imagine surgeons doing surgery. Very cool. Very cool.
Now let's dive into media solutions. One cool feature that you might already experience, especially if you use a platform like YouTube, is AI dubbing. AI listens to your voice, learns your speech pattern, recreate it digitally, and translate it into another language, all while keeping it sound natural and uniquely you. I did one recording and translated it to Spanish. Let's hear it.
Hello, I am Julian. How are you? I'm very good. You good too? I'm good too. We are all good.
Hola, soy Julian. ¿Qué tal? Estoy muy bien. Tú también bien, también estoy bien. Todos estamos bien.
Next is cloud gaming. To be honest, I've never been a fan of cloud gaming because as JulianTechTM, I do have proper PCs and I'd rather just run it on hardware. But honestly, that was mostly ignorance on my part. Because here at Tencent, I tried their cloud gaming powered by, of course, EdgeOne.
And they developed games solely for cloud gaming, where instead of needing to install a game to play, you can access the game just by a website link. And these games are not simple games, it's full-fledged games.
We probably didn't see any of these games because a lot of these games are in Chinese and are for the Chinese market. But let's see another interesting application that way. What you're seeing here is these pandas and the environment are rendered in the cloud in real time. You can change the lighting and even add particles like the leaves and flowers. Instead of designing for video games, this is more for displays and banners. Think of it like a dynamic banner. Some potential use case in my mind is maybe an amusement park, having like Disney or Pixar characters, pop-up stores for commercial storefronts, and even government and corporations, because a lot of times they have campaigns or projects that are not permanent fixtures. So you can just have a screen and an internet connection and you can get real-time rendering.
Now let's head back to the hackathon. Here we are following one of the top teams from Thailand, a group called AC4. The team is made up of three members who go by their nicknames: Captain, Ply, and Guide. Before they even got here, they had to go through a tough selection process with over 100 entries from around the world. For the first stage, they have submitted a game they have been developing called Leap of Blades. This game runs on Tencent servers, so you can actually try it out yourself. Here's how it works. It's a vertical scroller action game where it's constantly moving upwards. You use your mouse to slash enemies and every successful hit lets you chain another slash mid-air. But if you miss, you fall and you lose life. As you progress, the game gets tougher, the platforms get further apart, forcing you to think quickly and react even faster. The game definitely needs more fine-tuning, especially in balance and level design. But when you pull off some combo slashes, it feels damn satisfying. It's a great example of what a small team can do with passion and creativity. And with Leap of Blades, AC4 managed to break into the top 10 team worldwide. And that's why they are here today. I sat down with the team and asked them a few questions about their experience. What have been the toughest challenge so far?
Coming here and adapt to the environment, working environment, coding environment, internet, Wi-Fi, something like that.
How has Tencent EdgeOne platform helped you during development?
Yeah, it's helped me deploy our game playable easily on a WebGL, on the website. It's helped to store some data for players and make it more interesting.
How do you want players to feel when playing your game?
That they must feel fun. Yeah, fun. Okay. I hope they have fun and feel that it's special. It's something new. Yeah, we try to make something new.
Now let's see what they managed to create in just 48 hours. They had to present this game to a panel of judges. Their new game is called Wildcast, and it's a unique mix of auto chess meets tower defense meets Plants vs Zombies. Here's how it works. Every round, there'll be a random animal to your hand. Each animal has its own attack patterns, range, and damage. Your goal is simple. Stop the enemies from reaching to the left side of the screen and attacking you. As the round progresses, you encounter special cards that boost your animals or increasing your stats, adding layers of strategy to each match. Just like Leap of Blades, you can play this game for yourself. And while it's very rough, the core gameplay is surprisingly fun. It does get a bit repetitive, but considering they built this in only 48 hours, you can really feel the potential shining through. Once the team finished presenting Wildcast, the panel of judges will ask follow-up questions.
Can you tell me anything that you guys are planning to build or currently build to differentiate from other games like this?
The player character has different attack range, right? So the placement of the character is crucial into like winning the game, or at least let you survive longer. And the longer it takes, the enemy will also get stronger also. So we have the design and upgrades that are interesting and unique.
We all know tower games are kind of similar. It's really easy for the player or the users to feel tense. Can you tell me anything that you try to implement or you already implement making things not that kind of repetitive?
We haven't implemented anything that really diverse in this build because the time is really limited. but I try to have a limit on the number of enemy on the field and make sure that the damage number does not exceed the number of the enemy.
Now the judges have to tally up all the scores and we go to the awards ceremony where we find out AC4 God! Drumroll please! AC4 God! Second place! They've won 20,000 Chinese yen, that's about 3,500 Singapore dollars. The first place took home 10,000 US dollars. It's EcoQuest for their game PokePlanet. It's kind of like 2042, where instead of combining numbers, you combine animals. If you ask me if the competition was which game was more fun, AC4 hands down won it. But I'm sure EcoQuest did very well in other areas.
And that wraps up my time here at the Tencent Cloud Summit 2025. We've seen the PalmAI, the audio dubbing, EdgeOne, the VR robot control. It's easy to forget how massive Tencent reach is. Across 21 regions with 3,200 global acceleration nodes, a serving 80 markets across 30 industries. God damn. This is the backbone behind everything we experience here. And a global hackathon was a perfect showcase of how easy this platform is and how developers are already building on this platform. Seeing all this firsthand has really opened up my eyes. It's so clean, you know, it's everything so nice and clean. But thank you so much, Tencent, for inviting me. I really enjoyed my time here and hope you enjoyed this video. I'll see you on the next one, and I'm done.